You'll understand the relevancy of this Tom Petty joint in just a moment. Bear with me here. In addition to pumping out the content on Toronto Mic'd, I produce shows for other people. One show I'm proud to produce is the Humble and Fred Show. A while back, Freddie P. gave me a box of old cassette tapes. The hope was that these tapes were full of nostalgic Humble and Fred gold from the 1990s. Instead, the overwhelming majority of these tapes were from the 1.5 years Humble Howard left CFNY, and Freddie P., for that matter, for Mix 99.9. Fun fact, Humble Howard is the first person to say Mix 99.9 on the air. But I digress. One of these cassette tapes is from March 1st, 1990. It's kind of an interesting episode because you get to hear that transition period for CFNY when they were still playing New Order and Orchestral Maneuvers in the Dark, but they added in some Rolling Stones, Maestro Fresh Wes, and even Tom Petty. That's right. Tom Petty's Won't Back Down is played on the Humble and Fred Show on 102.1 on March 1st, 1990. But you'll hear that later in this episode. I find this episode also interesting because Humble Howard starts off in the studio with Freddie P. and their producer Dan Duran. But then about, I don't know, halfway through the show, he gets driven to the airport and continues the show on his cell phone because he's got a flight to catch at Pearson. I'm trying to envision the 1990s cell phone. Is it like the Zach Morris brick? Is it a flip phone? I didn't have a mobile phone in 1990, but Howard did. And you'll hear in this episode how he keeps the show going while trying to get a flight to San Francisco. So hop in the time machine with me. We're going way back to March 1st, 1990. And yes, you'll hear about the Leafs beating the Quebec Nordiques about a half dozen times. But that's because this is as it was recorded on that cassette tape on March 1st, 1990. Enjoy responsibly.
Also the Rolling Stones. Duran Duran, Burning the Ground. And also the Rolling Stones before that. Rock and a Hard Place. It's 15 after 6. Our producer, Dan Duran, actually was one of the founding members of the band Duran Duran. Dan, can you tell us what happened?
Well, I was, I am the whole group. I was apart for a while there. I split up, but I got myself back together again.
Very good. We're going to play Dial a Dave for you in a few moments' time. Your chance to win some Bowie tickets. Also, Trivia Challenge is coming up. In the news this morning, all you have to remember is this. No matter what else happens, remember that John Crosby hurled a sexist insult at Sheila Kopp, he's drawn some outrageous demands for his resignation, mm-hmm. and all you have to remember is what he said. First, we'll say it, mm-hmm. Fred.
Mm-hmm. You want me to say it?
Yeah.
Pass me the tequila, Sheila. Lie down and love me again.
And now we'll sing it. Pass me the tequila. Pass me the tequila, Sheila. Lie down and love me again.
Something. Four-story funhouse at the corner of Queen and Bathurst.
Girls' Night Out Thursdays at the Big Bop.
8-7-0. That's a fine time from New Order at CFNY. FM 102, our time is 6:22. It's Humble and Fred, high near 4 degrees today. And windy, though. Sunny and nice is the forecast, minus 10, warming up tomorrow, too.
We can only hope that's a warm wind they're talking about today.
Well, I think it might be. Because the trend in the next couple of days is going to be warmer on the weekend, which is perfect because that big golf show is coming to the Dome. Start thinking about golf. It's the 1st of March, so golf can't be that far away. Another month and a half.
Yeah, that big golf show at the Dome is going to be something. They're going to have the world's longest or biggest driving range or something.
They're going to throw up a huge net, and you can go there. They're going to have a putting green, which is no big deal, but they're going to have a sand trap and a driving range. You can just slap balls into the Dome. It gets underway tonight, and it goes right through the weekend.
Mm-hmm.
It's 6:23. We've got Tom Fogarty of Brampton to play Dial a Dave in just a minute.
Paper.
Next Wednesday, not only does David Bowie come to Toronto, to the Sky Dome, but next Wednesday morning, Fred and I will open up these here phone lines and take the 102nd caller and give away a trip to Bowie live in London. This morning, though, it's of a more local nature. Hi, Tom.
Good morning.
How are you this morning?
Excellent, excellent.
Very nice. You are our fifth caller on the Dial of Dave Sound. And also, there's something else going on in your life this morning, I understand.
Yeah, my mom's birthday is today. She turned 65.
Well, congratulations. 65, she lives in Boston.
Massachusetts.
Wow.
Is she a Canadian or...
No, she's an American.
Okay.
Well, lovely, Dave. Why do I keep calling you Dave?
Tom, I don't know. Everybody does that.
I do that, you know, because I'm thinking of David Bowie.
That's good.
Which you've just won a pair of tickets to, courtesy of Labatt's. It's the Sound and Vision Tour next Wednesday at the Dome.
Excellent, excellent.
Well, we hope you enjoy those.
Now, I really will. I really. This is a shock, I'll be honest with you.
Now, your pick for your David Bowie song this morning?
Changes.
And we'll send this out to your mom?
She might not hear it.
Oh, it's kind of a more cosmic thing, though. She'll feel it.
Sure. She'll pick us up in satellite.
Oh, of course. Everyone does. We're one of the finest stations in Boston.
Excellent station in Boston.
Take care, Tom.
Thank you very much.
It's Bowie and Changes from CFNY. CFNY. FM 102 and David Bowie's Changes. It's 6:29. It's Humble and Fred. Kim Karuba. She's got the traffic. Freddie has some sports. The Leafs just eked by last night, which is kind of scary when you think about it. They were playing the Nordiques Farm Club.
Yeah.
And Barb Hansen will be here. In fact, she is here. Goodness gracious, it's time for the news. Yes, exactly. It's time for the news.
Thanks, Howard.
It's a lovely thing.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Road crews doing some work westbound on the Gardner at the Humber. The right lane is blocked. Watch for a broken water main southbound on Bathurst, south of College, and a disabled vehicle westbound on Kingston Road and Queen. And that's CFNY traffic. I'm Kim Carruthers, now sports with Fred.
Well, immediately after the hockey game at the Gardens last night, Coach Doug Carpenter didn't look too pleased. In fact, he looked disgusted with the Leafs' shoddy 5-4 victory over the Quebec Nordiques. But later on, when he thought about the 2 points, he felt much better. Leafs built up a 4-1 lead in the first period, then held on in the third. They were lucky the Nordiques didn't tie it up. And please don't forget, the Nordiques are the worst team in the NHL. We got trapped a little bit, said the coach. They knocked us off our game, but we won. It was a chippy game with some highlights, like the performance of Vincent Damfus. He had a goal and 3 assists. Gary Lehman scored his 43rd goal of the season. Then he had to leave the game in the third period with a shoulder spasm, but he'll be okay. Now, with the victory, the Leafs extend their home unbeaten streak to 6 games, and they pull back within 3 points of third place St. Louis and the Norris. Leafs are in Detroit tomorrow night. On Saturday night, they host the Wings. Detroit beat the Islanders 4-3. The Wings have pulled within 1 point of Minnesota for the final playoff spot in the Norris. Rangers got by Washington 3-2. Rangers now have a 4-point lead atop the Patrick. Hartford dumped Montreal 3-1. LA beat Edmonton 4-2. It was a nutso game in LA. 7 players were thrown out for fighting. 85 penalties were called in the game, which sets an NHL record, 354 minutes. Vancouver and Philadelphia tied 7-7, and Pittsburgh beat Jersey 2-1. The baseball lockout continues. There were no new talks yesterday, but the possible start date gets bumped to March 10th. George Bell is in Dunedin. Every year, he refuses to report until March 1st. This year, despite the lockout, no different. George arrived yesterday. Argonauts' best player is free to cut a deal with anyone. Running back Gil Fenerty became a free agent at midnight last night, and he's waiting for NFL offers. Within reason, the Argos say they'll do all they can to keep the thrill. And there's a chance Calgary could end up hosting the 1992 Winter Olympics. The games have been awarded to Albertville, France, but that city is small, and they're having problems getting the facilities. Rumor has it, if things continue to falter, the IOC will ask Calgary to take over. Meanwhile, those involved in acquiring the 1996 Summer Games for Toronto are concerned. They're afraid consecutive Winter Games in Canada could spoil it for the Summer Games in TO. That's your sports. More information at 7 o'clock.
6:35 in the morning, 25 till 7. It's Hummel and Fred and Yazoo. Yes, it is. At FM 102, CFNY.
That's Yazoo.
Isn't Yazoo that guy from the Flintstones?
That was Kazoo. That was Kazoo.
Kazoo.
Oh, boy. Don't remind me. I love that show.
From FM 102, CFNY. It's Hummel and Fred, and it's Thursdays, which means we're looking for people who can sing, kind of.
Or hum, or la-la-la.
Da-da-da-da-da-da.
Mm-hmm.
It's a thematic Thursday.
Hum along harmonies.
You give us a TV or movie scene, uh-huh. And we're trying to guess it. 870-7700 and some nifty prizes. Chance for you to win this morning. The official Humble and Fred hockey stick.
That's an item, I'll tell you, that everybody wants.
Indeed they do. Also, tickets to the GM 70mm Film Festival. All you have to do is win it, and it's so easy. From CFNY FM 102. B-52s at CFNY FM 102. It's 6:44 in the morning. It's Humble and Fred, and a much pleasanter day is in store for us. A high of 4 degrees.
Yeah, March is coming in like a lamb, it appears.
Well, it's about time, because February just stunk. Trivia challenge is on the way. But as usual, doing a fine and lovely job for Rafferty's Restaurant, the home of the Humble and Fred Party Fun.
Mm-hmm.
It's Kim.
Emergency road repair is being done westbound on the Gardner at the Humber in the right lane. Other major routes filling in, we do have a stalled car westbound on Kingston Road at Queen and a broken water main in the right lane, southbound on Bathurst, south of College. And that's CFNY traffic. I'm Kim Carruthers. Trivia Challenge is next.
Every 6:45, 15 till 7.
Mm-hmm.
It's Humble and Fred, and Kim Karuba is here to help us with Trivia Challenge, as she does every morning.
Oh, and she is such a grand help.
Oh,
from,
okay, anytime.
From Unionville, hello to Eamon Wild.
Hi, how are you?
Very well. Eamon Wild. What a cool name.
Yeah, it's kind of funny, yeah.
What kind of name is that?
I don't know. I think it's a joke.
It's not your name?
I'm serious. I'm dead serious. Eamon Wild.
What are your parents' names?
Kevin and Angela.
Hmm. So they have kind of normal names. We're the Wilds. We're normal. We'll call our son Eamon Wild.
How old are you, Eamon?
I'm 17.
Mm-hmm. Well, listen, Eamon, it's great to have you on the show.
That's within the period where people started looking for cool names, you know?
I think your real name is probably...
Around there, yeah.
Your real name is probably like Roger or something. You said, no, I'm 17. I want to be called Eamon Wild.
Well, you're definitely not normal.
You'll notice the Ralphs and Freds are restricted to guys over 30s.
Yeah, that's mm-hmm. true.
Yep.
Listen, Eamon, what's your... is it going to be a movie theme or a TV theme?
TV theme.
Let's hear it.
Okay. Do 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 do.
Very nice, Eamon. You got us. What was that?
That was Rocket Robin Hood.
Oh, wait a second now. Wait a second now. Rocket Robin Hood?
Yeah, I'm serious.
Sing it for me. Because I think I know this one.
I don't know the words to it. I just know how it goes.
Rocket Robin Hood.
That's been on.
And brothers marching.
Oh, yeah.
For 25 years, that's been on in this market.
No.
Early morning, like 6 o'clock.
We got to apologize to Natasha, because we're not going to get time for her. I'm sorry, Natasha. Try us again next week.
Okay.
Sweetie, I'm sorry. Just 1 week from today, we'll put you on for sure. In the meantime, we'll say goodbye to Natasha. And Eamon,
yeah.
Pick a number between 1 and 14.
Give me a 2.
Oh, Eamon, hang on, everyone. Is Natasha gone? She's gone. Okay. Number 2?
Yeah, please.
Number 2.
Number 2.
Number 2.
Number 2.
2.
Whoa, number 2. Oh, you got the big one, a custom-carved, limited edition Humble and Fred hockey stick from Rewards by Design.
Great, thanks a lot.
You're very welcome. It's kind of cool. It's got our name carved right into the stick. And,
next time I'm playing street hockey, I'll use it.
Oh, yeah. It's a little small, I think, but it makes a fine collector's item, or, you know, you can hit yourself over the head with it.
Okay, or keep that in mind.
Or hit the radio over the head with it when we're on the air.
Okay, I'll do that. You got my word on it.
Hang on a second. It's 6:48, 12 till 7 o'clock. The loudest comedian in the world is coming to Toronto. We'll tell you about him in a second. From FM 102, CFNY. That's a safety dance. And Men Without Hats at CFNY, FM 102. It's Humble and Fred, Men Without Talent, 8 minutes till 7. And he is the loudest, screechinest, and one of the funniest comedians you'll have a chance to see. He's been in Toronto before. Of course, I'm talking about Sam. Some people in comics just call him Sam. Just Sam. Sam Kinison. He'll be at Massey Hall April 2nd. 2nd. Tickets go on sale today at Ticketmaster, Massey Hall, and RT Hall Box Office. And he'll include some highlights of his latest albums and also some of his singing. Leader of the band, B-A-N-N-E-D. Now, my sister-in-law mm-hmm. is a very proper Manchester English woman, and her and my brother came to visit me in Los Angeles. I thought, what am I going to do? I can Disneyland, take him down. So I took him to the Comedy Store to see Sam Kinison one night, and she's very, very upper crust and proper snobby girl.
Uh-oh.
So Sam comes on, and within about 15 seconds, I looked over at her. You know that guy in the Maxell commercial where his hair is flying back?
All right.
She was like going, oh, my God. Oh, my, oh, no. And he's there going, ha, ha, ha. And me and my brother are laughing, and she's just like, oh my God. So if you have anyone you'd like to hear that reaction from, you know, take him to see Sam.
Take him to see Sam.
but leave your mom and your kids at home, that's for sure.
The sea and less.
656, one of the hottest songs, not only in Canada, but all across North America, from a Toronto fellow. Is that right, Neil? He's a Toronto guy, yeah. He's doing very well. Maestro, Fresh West, at CFNY FM 102.
This rap's back. Give me blackjacks, a mosquito, play cheetah fly.
Maestro, Fresh West, let your backbone slide at CFNY FM 102 at 7 o'clock. And with the news, here's Mary Ellen Benninger.
Traffic and transit update.
We've got crews repairing the roadway westbound on the Gardiner at the Humber. They are blocking the right lane. Bell Canada reaching out and touching the curved lane southbound on Dufferin at Glen Cairn, and a broken water main southbound on Bathurst south of College. And that's CFNY traffic. I'm Kim Carruthers. Fred has sports next.
How to make your morning.
7:04 in the morning, 4 past 7 o'clock for Labatt's with sports. Here he is, the Fred Man.
And the Maple Leafs won ugly at the Gardens last night. They built up a 4-1 first period lead and then hung on to beat the worst team in the NHL, 5-4, Quebec Nordiques. The 2 points come in handy, however. They pull within 3 points of second place St. Louis in the Norris Division. Gary Lehman scored his 43rd goal of the year. Vincent Danfus had a goal in three. Detroit beat the Islanders 4-3. Wings have pulled within 1 point of Minnesota for the final playoff spot in the Norris. Rangers got by Washington 3-2. Hartford upset Montreal 3-1. Pittsburgh beat Jersey 2-1. LA beat Edmonton 4-2. And Vancouver and Philadelphia tied 7-7. There was no baseball settlement yesterday, so another day has been chopped off the exhibition schedule. March 10th, now the new possible start date. George Bell, he's in Dunedin, always reports to Dunedin at the last minute, March 1st, but despite the lockout, this year no different. He arrived yesterday. Several CFL players became free agents yesterday, among them the Argos' Gil Fenerty, and there's a slight chance Calgary could end up as host of the 1992 Winter Olympics. That's your sports. More detail at 7:30.
Live from the home of the Great Pyramids of Tutankhamun. Wait a second, who writes these? Live from Toronto, it's hour two of the Humble and Fred Show. Coming up, the Radio Angels, Police Blotter, and an experiment involving time, airplanes, and Pearson International. And now, two men trusted by millions to lead them down the garden path to that mucky area where most people pile the dog poo, Humble and Fred.
Humble and Fred, go back to bed.
7:06 in the morning, 6 minutes after 7 o'clock. Dino. Also the Brat Pack. And OMD on the way.
Don't forget the Radio Angels.
We have a lovely call to a lovely gal. But first, Simple Minds. And don't you forget at CFNY FM 102. Simple Minds, and don't you forget about me at 11 minutes after 7 o'clock, 7:11 in the morning. And we're going to don Wing and Halo and call somebody.
Mm-hmm.
It's the Radio Angels.
You look so sweet in the Halo, Howard.
Thank you very much, Brent. It's beautiful South now. Well, there's the beautiful South, and you keep it all in. At FM 102 CFNY, 7:14 in the morning, 14 after 7, an interesting situation for us Toronto dwellers develops today. It's the fact that now, if normally you dial long distance, you have to put the 416 in front of it.
That's right. For example, if someone lived in Hamilton before, you would dial 1 and then the number because it was the same area code. Now, if it's long distance within the same area code, you have to dial 1-416 and then the number.
It's, you know, here's the thing. It's like, you know, Toronto is growing up. It's like a lot of large cities. Los Angeles is one of them. You can be in the 213 area code and live across the street from the 818 area code, and it's a long distance call.
Really? But apparently this move opens up like another couple hundred thousand phone numbers.
And maybe we'll put an end to those goofy commercials we've been hearing about. Oh, you got any numbers? Yeah, I got a number for you. It's 1. 14 after 7. 7:14 in the morning, and in traffic, here's Kim.
Thanks, Howard. Slower than usual on the Gardiner westbound through the Humber. We've got crews fixing the road. The right lane is blocked. Southbound on the 404, watch for a minor delay through John Street because of an earlier accident. A disabled truck blocking a lane eastbound on the QE at Cawthra, and police clearing an accident eastbound on the 403 west of Erin Mills. and that's CFNY Traffic. I'm Kim Carruthers. The Radio Angels are next.
The Spotlight has
400 now.
7:16 in the morning, 16 after 7. Jeff Ashcroft is on the phone with us. Hi, Jeff.
Morning.
Good morning. You're in Toronto already.
Yep.
But you commute down from Newmarket.
That's right.
All right. Now, your wife is the lady we're calling. And can you briefly describe what her situation is and why we're calling her?
Well, the reason we're calling her is she's been really depressed lately. Every February, you know, like a lot of people, she gets into the blues. But this year, our two children, though we love them very much, are going through all the worst stages at the same time, like teeth and potty training and a lot of sickness. And since I've had
to
work...
And what about the kids?
What about the kids?
I'm just kidding.
Oh, I can identify with that. I know where you're coming from, pal.
Yeah.
So you have one child that is 8 months.
Yep.
And the other is just about three.
That's right. Ooh,
that's
three
rough.
Next week.
There's a lot of running around involved, huh?
Mm-hmm.
So what kind of state of mind is Debbie in these days?
Oh, she's really low.
She's got the giant, you know, post-February bums.
Oh, yeah. It's the worst I've ever seen it.
Really?
Yeah. I've been trying, you know, everything to try and get her to cheer up, but it hasn't been working, so I was counting on you guys to give me a hand.
Well, I'll tell you something. You've got an interesting line here about you had to cancel a trip to Florida.
Great.
And such. He says, in other words, I had to turn off the light at the end of the tunnel. Hi, is Debbie there, please?
Speaking.
Debbie, this is Humble Howard, Fred Patterson, and your husband Jeff on the phone.
Yes.
And we're the Radio Angels at CFNY.
Right.
Have you ever heard of us?
Yeah.
Well, the reason we're calling you... Well, Jeff, tell Debbie the reason we're calling you.
Well, just because you've been so down lately with February blues, and the kids have been a bit of a handful, and I've had to work late, I just thought we'd give you a call and try and cheer you up.
Oh, all right.
Debbie?
Yeah?
We want to make things a little easier on you. So what we're going to do is give you a $102 port credit shopping spree, dinner at Reuben and Wong's for you and Jeff to kind of, you know, take a night out.
Mm-hmm.
Also, I know you guys had to cancel your trip to Florida.
Right.
So here's, we got something else for you, too.
We're going to give you a pair of tickets to the Blue Jays exhibition game at the Skydome March 17th, but game or no game, we'll still gather at the Skydome Hotel and give away 12 trips to Florida, so you have a chance at one of those 12 trips.
Debbie, here's your chance. You have a 1 in 7 chance of going to Florida anyway. We'll pay for it. We'll give you $500 in Visa traveler's checks. We'll give you a rental car. We'll give you a hotel. We'll give you airfare down there, okay?
Oh, that'd be nice.
So can we hear a little smile?
Slightly.
All right, Debbie. You listen, Jeff?
Yeah.
You hang on a second. We'll give you some details.
Okay, great.
And we hope this makes a little bit makes things a little bit easier.
Okay, that's great.
Okay, you guys take care.
Okay.
Remember, they won't be babies forever.
That's right. It won't be February forever, right?
That's right. 7:19 in the morning, 19 after 7 o'clock. It's Humble and Fred and Dino from FM 102 CFNY. Or is it Dino?
That's angel music.
It is angel music. It still is angel music. You guys still there?
Yeah, we're
still
here.
Well, you know, that's it. Now we're in kind of you know, the post we're in the denouement where we've climaxed the point and it's over.
Twilight Zone.
So there we go. That's not Dino. No, that's not Dino. Oh it's Orchestral Maneuvers in the Dark. My fault. Locomotion at CFNY FM 102. CFNY FM 102 with Humble and Fred at 7:24. Who's this on the phone?
It's Marco.
Hi, Marco. What's on your mind?
Well, I don't know about this, but you guys just made a mistake.
No.
Yeah.
What kind of mistake?
Big mistake.
Huge?
Well, not huge, but it was minor, pretty medium.
What would that be? What mistake is that, Marco? Go ahead and tell us.
Well, you just made a mistake on a song, on OMD, Orchestral Maneuvers.
Well, no, that was Orchestral Maneuvers in the Dark.
It certainly was, but yep. It wasn't Locomotion.
What?
No, it was Tesla Girls.
It was Tesla Girls?
Oh, boy.
Well, my Lord.
You caught us.
Wow. Well, you know, we have that contest. If you catch us playing the wrong song,
right,
anytime in our show, we give you a prize.
Oh, you do.
That's a new contest we're starting now.
Great.
If it's not the song we say it is, This will be called the 6 to 9 song is screwed up weekday morning. You get a prize if you catch us thing.
You like that?
Yeah.
Tell you what you get, Marco.
You're going to get a pair of tickets to the Blue Jays game against the St. Louis Cardinals March 17th at the Sky Dome. No game. We're still going to get together and give away 12 trips to Florida, and you qualify now for one of those trips.
Right on,
Marco.
Courtesy La Bats.
Marco, what do you do for a living?
I go to school.
What grade are you in?
10.
Grade 10. Okay, let's see. Grade 10. Because our producer, Dan Duran, when he's not here, you know, he might need someone to fill in. Let's see. Grade 10. Can you count? Do this for me. Count to 5.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Very good. Count to 5. It's grade 10. Count to 5. Are you prone to tripping over stuff?
I don't know.
Okay, well, you can check that off. Let me see. Can you spell your name for me?
M-A-R-C-O.
You got the job, Marco. Sometimes if Dan's not here or something,
yeah.
Boom.
All right.
We're going to have you come in and do it.
That's great.
All right. Thanks, Marco.
No problem.
Don't go away. We'll tell you how you get your tickets.
Okay.
726 and Adino, or not, next. 728. Yes, it's Humble and Fred. 728. Thank you. Are you loving us? Makes me feel better. And Dino now. I like it. It's CFNY. That's Dino. And that's the way I like it. At FM 102 CFNY, it's 731. An unheard of experiment involving airport travel in the city of Toronto. We'll tell you about that coming up. Also,
it's going to be very interesting.
Very
to see
strange,
how this pans
too,
out.
Yes. Also, police blotters on the way, but first with the news, it's 7:31, it's a Barb.
Good
day.
Road crews should have cleared their construction equipment by now. Westbound on the Gardner through the Humber might still be a minor delay. A broken down vehicle blocking a lane on the Queenie eastbound at Cawthra. Watch for an accident on the 403 eastbound west of Erin Mills. That long distance feeling in the curb lane as Bell makes some adjustments. Southbound on Dufferin at Glen Cairn, and crews repairing a broken water main. Southbound on Bathurst, south of College. And that's CFNY traffic. I'm Kim Carruthers, now sports with Freddie for Labatt's.
Well, the Maple Leafs got 2 points at the Gardens last night. Nothing to be proud of, but what the heck, it goes into the win column. They beat the worst team in the NHL, the Quebec Nordiques, 5-4. Coach Doug Carpenter, right at the end of the game, you saw him on television. He looked disgusted with it, but after he had time to calm down, he said, hey, they were on us a bit. We got trapped a little bit, but we won. We got the 2 points. They knocked us off our game. Give them credit. Okay, it was a chippy game. Some highlights, like the performance of Vincent Damfus. He had a goal and 3 assists. Gary Lehman scored his 43rd goal of the season. Then he had to leave the game in the third period with a shoulder spasm, but he'll be okay. With the victory, the Leafs extend their home unbeaten streak to 6 games, and they pull back within 3 points of second-place St. Louis in the Norris. Leafs are in Detroit tomorrow night. On Saturday night, they host the Wings, a chance, you know, to grab at least 4 points, we would hope. Detroit beat the Islanders 4-3 last night. Wings have pulled within 1 point of Minnesota for the final playoff spot in the Norris. Rangers got by Washington 3-2. Rangers now have a 4-point lead atop the Patrick division. Hartford dumped Montreal 3-1. L.A. beat Edmonton. This was a crazy game in L.A. 7 players thrown out for fighting. 85 penalties were called in the game. That sets an NHL record. The penalty minute total, 354. Vancouver and Philadelphia tied 7-7, and Pittsburgh beat Jersey 2-1. Scary news about Mario Lemieux. Apparently, his career could be in jeopardy. He was told about his back problems years ago, but never took advice on how to avoid chronic problems. Now, he's in serious trouble. The baseball lockout continues. There were no new talks yesterday, so the possible start date gets bumped back to March 10th. George Bell is in Dunedin. Every year, he refuses to report until March 1st. This year, despite the lockout, no different. He's there. Argonauts' best player is free to cut a deal with anyone. Running back Gil Frenerty became a free agent at midnight last night, and he's waiting for NFL offers. The Argos say, within reason, they'll do all they can to keep the thrill, and there's a chance Calgary could end up hosting the 1992 Winter Olympics. The town of Albertville, France, is having problems getting their facilities ready, and the IOC is concerned they might be a little small, so they've asked Calgary to stand by just in case Albertville can't do it. That's your sports, a presentation of Labatt's. More information at 8 o'clock.
7:38 in the morning, 22 minutes until 8 o'clock. It's Humble and Fred.
Good morning.
And a fine Boys Day, the 1st of March. Looking better already, too. It's going to be warmer for a change. In the meantime, Brat Pack at CFNY. Beloved and hello. at FM 102 CFNY. It's Humble and Fred, 7:45. We have a program announcement to make. Tomorrow morning and on Monday morning, it's going to be our pal Humble Hal.
Mm-hmm.
Hal Harbour and his wacky show. He'll be here. It's going to be fun because I listen to him on Saturday mornings when he does the All Request Breakfast, and it's very entertaining. And he's a great guy. He knows a lot about music, and he's very funny. You'll have a good time with him. I'm leaving the country myself.
Yeah, you're leaving on a jet plane.
Here's the thing we were going to do. We'll tell you more about this in a minute. We're going to do an experiment. Try and get to Pearson International Airport in rush hour traffic. I have a 9:30 plane to catch, so I'm going to do the show with Jamie McBoombox via cellular phone for the last hour.
And you know, the neat thing about this is you could have got a flight around noon or so, but for the sake of
this program, we're going to try and cut it as close as we can. And you watch, I'll just get to customs. I go, no, sorry, pal. No, we don't take your kind into this country, buddy. In the meantime, for Sing, where next Wednesday night we'll be singing some more, here's Kim in traffic.
Thank you. S-401 slows through Jane Eastbound on the 403, busy through Aaron Mills because of earlier problems. Other major arteries typically busy, but they are accident-free, so you might make it to the airport, Howard. Two recent accidents in town, northbound on Keel through Shepherd and on Avenue Road through Chaplin. And the CFNY street of the day, rather fitting, I'd say, Knob Hill.
Oh, yes. Fitting for the program.
And that's CFNY traffic. I'm Kim Carruthers. Police Blotter's coming up.
Reservations, call YOU-SING.
Attention all units. Attention all units. Stand by for Humble and Fred's Police Blotter.
This is the city, Toronto, Ontario, Canada. I work here. I'm a cop.
Me too.
Me too, too.
It was Thursday, March 1st. I was working the blotter with my dunderhead partners, Constable Fred and Detective Dan.
Dunderhead.
That's a compliment. In police terms.
Is that a promotion?
Yes, okay, actually, thanks. Constable Dunderhead. It's a big step up for both of you. How about a little story, and then maybe a song before nap time.
Okay, Captain. Captain,
yes.
In Norval, a candidate for mayor wants to take a bite at a crime by turning criminals into shark bait. Ned Greaser would build a ship with a false bottom.
This is Toronto.
Pardon me?
Oh, I'm sorry. Ned Greaser would build a ship with a false bottom and then load it with hardened criminals. The bottom would be opened in the high seas, and rapists, thieves, drug dealers, kidnappers, and financial speculators, oh, they're the worst, will be thrown to the sharks.
Uh-oh.
I like it.
It's a fine idea.
More from the blotter on
Tuesday.
But first, here's Captain Humble with this morning's safety tip.
This comes to us from Constable Junior Craig L. Milton of Burlington, Ontario. It's really more of a message to his friend Sean than a safety tip, but something we can all enjoy, I think. He says, remember, kids, when you go over to someone's house for a party and the host says, help yourself, the beer's in the fridge, be thankful. Show your appreciation. Kindness is a virtue. Reward those who show you generosity. Don't go over the next night and help yourself to the beer again. And again the next night, and yet again the next morning, and the day after that, and so on for years and years. He says, try bringing a case of beer over for once in your life, Sean. Or the generous host who has been paying for your drinks all year can suddenly take a mean twist. He'll fill you with brews till you can't walk. You'll pass out in the loo with your pants to your ankles. The host will sneak in with a Polaroid, snap a couple of shots, and send them to America's Most Wanted. As a sought-after beer leech, you'll be sitting at home with your newfound adoration watching television, and suddenly your face and other body parts will be made public on national television. You'll turn red, gasp for an explanation, but it's too late. Your mother was watching the program upstairs, trembles down the stairs with a large frying pan, and
you could be killed.
Trash Vegas,
babe. And FM 102 CFNY. It's Humble and Fred at 7:54. It's going to be a nice day today, too.
Hey, it's so nice to hear. It's the 1st of March.
Mm-hmm. And, you know, we can just look forward to it getting better and better as the weeks go on.
Yeah, the city's trying to save on salt because of that salt strike. And, of course, we've always recommended using Mrs. Dash.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, use that. It's not going to storm that much anymore. A little dash, a little sand. That's all you need. Hal Harbour's on the phone.
Hi.
Hi, Hal.
Hi.
I thought it was very nice, very sweet of Hal to call and say, is there any do's and don'ts in the show? Well, we'd like you to be better than us if you could, which is not going to be too difficult.
Oh, boy, that's going
to
be a...
No, Hal. I've heard your Saturday morning show. You're going to kick our butts, and it'll be fun to listen to for a couple of days.
So you have a good trip.
Okay, listen, you're going to do... You really can't do the all request thing tomorrow.
No.
But you'll be doing Dial a Dave. You got some Jay's tickets to give away.
Hey, neat.
And you'll have Kim and Mary Ellen and Barb. And, well, unfortunately, we've got to leave Dan with you.
Oh.
Okay.
Hal? Well. Hal, will you be doing a few? Will you be doing a few of those?
Do I have to?
No. Fred, just leave Hal alone. He's a good guy. Hal, thanks for calling.
Okay.
7:55. Here's what we're going to try and do from our studios in Brampton. We're going to be driving to Pearson International. It's rush hour. Jamie McBoombox is here, and you're going to be driving.
Road Warrior style.
A little closer, Jamie. It's a microphone, pal.
All right.
Road Warrior style. We're going to get there. I got to go through customs. I'm going to have a cellular phone. You're going to be my my bodyguard.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I'm going to actually take you a little bit of off-roading. There's some rather unique fields I know of.
Oh, neat.
Yeah.
We got a big hourglass here. We're going to see if Howard can do it.
Now, here's the scary thing. Fred and Dan. Mm-hmm. Fred and Dan are actually going to be taking over the show. I'll be in the mobile via cellular. We'll be waving at people, and please try not to run us off the road.
Ha-ha.
And this starts in 4 minutes' time. 7:56, 4 till 8 o'clock. Fred and Dan will be here. I'll still be doing the show with you.
Mm-hmm.
We're still going to do Trivia Challenge. We'll be doing most of the show, except I'll be on the road doing it to try and squeeze into this flight.
We're going to miss you, Howard.
Oh, I'm going to miss you too, Cam.
We send us a postcard?
No, I won't. I don't believe in the mail. I don't believe in it.
He'll be back for a week and a half before we got it.
Exactly. Mary Ellen Benninger has the news after the Beatles. That's the Beatles, Lucy and the Sky, from the roots of modern rock at FM 102 CFNY. The show is going to continue, as normal. Well, as normal as it ever is. Mayor, I'm on my way to Pearson, which should be an experience.
I'm not saying anything about that airport. I've slammed it enough lately.
Oh, man. If I even get to the airport in time, I'll be happy. If you see us on the road, please try not to crowd us, because Jamie McBoombox is driving.
Get out of their way.
It's 8 o'clock. Mrs. Benninger has the news.
Good.
43rd goal of the year last night, but had to leave in the third period with a spasm in his shoulder. He's okay. Detroit beat the Islanders 4-3. Wings have pulled within 1 point of Minnesota for the final playoff spot in the Norris. Rangers got by Washington 3-2. Hartford upset Montreal 3-1. Pittsburgh beat Jersey 2-1. LA over Edmonton 4-2. Vancouver and Philadelphia tied 7-7. There was no baseball settlement yesterday, so another day has been chopped off the exhibition schedule. March 10th is the new possible start date. Several CFL players became free agents yesterday, among them the Argos' Gil Fennerty, and there's a chance Calgary could end up as host of the 1992 Winter Olympics. That's your sports, a presentation of Labatt's. More detail at 8:30.
Live from the world's biggest airport parking lot, it's hour three of the Humble and Fred Show. Coming up, Humble takes to the road to catch a plane or die trying. Fred and Dan do the show on their own, and demons may rise up from the lake and destroy us all. Also, great music from the Beatmasters, Tom Petty and Con Can. And now, two men you may find in the Sunshine Boy slot next week, Humble and Fred.
Humble and Fred, set that dial, don't touch those knobs.
At, I don't know, 11 after 8? Is that right?
Yep, that's just about right. Yes, 8:11, Howard.
It's Humble and Fred. I'm on the road. I'm on Kennedy Road and just getting up to Derry Road East. I'm trying to get to Pearson International, but I don't know. We got 20 minutes to make.
We got about
19
minutes.
19 minutes. No. We got to be there by 8:30. That's our goal. And then, of course, I'll be running through the airport with my mobile phone.
How's the traffic flow? Does it look good, Howard?
No, it doesn't. No. You know what? I'm behind a guy in a... What is that, Jamie? It's a Firebird, Pontiac, Thunderbird. It's a Skoda. I'm behind Mr. Goohead in his Skoda this morning, which is holding things up. He's one of those guys you see making a left turn around the planet.
All right.
Yeah, no matter where he's going, he's got his left signal light on, and he's making his left turn. We're going to try and do business as usual, though. It's time for our trivia challenge today. It's Thematic Thursday.
Yes, Hum Along Harmonies. Sing or hum or la-la the theme song from any movie or TV show, and we'll try and guess it.
870-7700. In the meantime, Hey, DJ, I can't dance. And this morning it's for me, I can't drive either. It's Betty Boo at CFNY FM 102. And, I don't know. It's just packed.
Oh, Howard, this is so wacky, isn't it?
I'm telling you, it's 8:16 in the morning. It's typical. There we go. I got some guy honking at me now in a tempo. Hi, Mr. Tempo guy. Honk your horn again. Go ahead. He's waving at me now. Honk at people and get them really mad at us.
He's just happy because he's driving one of the hottest selling cars in North America.
Well, thanks for that plug, Fred. you open up a dealership or what? We're on our way to Airport Road, and does a snowball's chance in hell mean anything to you people? That's the chance we have to get there by 8:30. I have to ask you though.
Did you get cancellation insurance for these tickets?
It's 16 after 8 o'clock, and we'll have a trivia challenge in a minute. But first, in traffic. Here's Kim.
Well, you're in traffic, Howard. Is it that bad?
It sucks. I'm telling you, I had no idea that it's just jammy. It's jammed up with people.
Well, we'll keep our fingers crossed for you.
Sure, but it's a bright, sunshiny day.
Ah, eastbound on the Queenie, a little slow from Mississauga Road to Cawthra. Other major routes, actually lighter than usual, and they are in good shape.
Kim?
Yeah?
I just saw a plane taking off. That doesn't bode well for me, does it?
Thanks to George for calling to report a stalled car in the center lane, northbound on the Allen, just below Shepherd. Earlier problems causing delays eastbound on Steeles, approaching the 404, and a broken water main still blocking the right lane, southbound on Bathurst, south of College. And that's CFNY traffic. I'm Kim Carruthers. Trivia Challenge is next.
It's time now for Trivia Challenge, and this is our first ever edition of Mobile Challenge.
That's right. It's 8:18 in the morning, and I got a guy next to me in the car here. How you doing? Good. I'm Howard. I'm trying to get to the airport. Can you do this? Honk your horn for me. Very cool. Can you just smash through people so I get there on time? Oh, forget it. People used to be more cooperative in the wagon train days. Anyway, we got Donna Thompson on the line. Hi, Donna.
Hi.
How are you this morning?
I'm not bad. How are you?
Well, I'm frightened.
So am I.
No, why are you frightened?
Because you're going to guess it. I know it.
Oh, you're scared we're going to guess this?
Yeah.
Well, obviously, we've never heard the show before. Okay, well, go ahead. It's a TV theme or a movie theme?
Well, it's a TV show.
All right, let's hear it.
Okay.
Sure.
Go ahead. I know it. You have
it. Well, I got a Partridge Family.
The what?
The Partridge Family.
No,
Howard.
Oh, sorry.
I won.
It was the
What was it?
The Brady Bunch.
Oh, I guessed wrong.
Yeah.
Oh, good.
I think you wanted Donna to get a good prize.
Donna, pick a number between 1 and 14.
Oh, 7.
Number 7.
Number 7.
7.
Number 7. Oh, dinner at Reuben and Wong's.
At where?
At Reuben and Wong's, the deli and Chinese restaurant.
Oh, great.
Glad
you
like
it. They were clapping
there? Yeah, that was clapping for you. That was applause.
Great.
See, we don't have much substance on the show, but we got plenty of style.
And neat prizes.
And neat prizes. Listen, Donna.
Yes.
I'm on my way to the airport, so cross your fingers for us.
Alrighty.
All right. In the meantime, some great music at 8:20 in the morning. It's the Stranglers. Ooh, what a classic. 96 Tears at CFNY, FM 102. That's the Stranglers and 96 Tears and a little phone fun here. It's Tumble and Fred. I'm in the cruiser, the mobile cruiser with Jamie McBoombox. I'm on the way to the airport. I think we're approaching Airport Road, Fred.
Let's have an update. What do you think?
It's 8:23 now. I'm not going to make it by 8:30. There's no chance in hell.
So then what?
Well, what happened is I forgot to mention this morning. I forgot my ticket. My wife, Randy, are you there?
Yes, I'm here.
Is this, the love connection?
Oh, yeah. My wife's in another phone.
Wait a minute.
What?
Can you let me tell a story for a quick second?
Oh, go ahead. Oh, pardon me.
I want to mention that this morning you were quick to mention that I stole the covers for you and you were left shivering.
Yeah.
Sure, but you don't tell anyone that you forgot your airline ticket.
Are you finished?
Yes.
Whose show is this, honey?
Not only did he forget the airline tickets, at one point he thought he had lost the airline tickets. Mm-hmm.
So Randy's at the Air Canada terminal now. So here's what you do. You go get the ticket. Remember, window seat, I don't want to sit beside any huge people.
So you want me to check you in?
Yeah.
All right.
What do you mean, all right?
Sure.
Well, you think it's a dumb idea?
Well, providing that I get the seat that you want.
Well, listen, honey, can you do that and we'll meet you at the terminal?
Sounds great to me.
Okay, Temple and Fred, 824. And, Freddie, it's going to be a fairly nice day. High of 4 degrees. It's chilly right now. It feels cool.
Well, it's going to have some wind today.
Minus 10 degrees and Concan is next.
Why?
It's 826. We made Airport Road. We're right beside a guy in an Al's Express truck who's looking. And we're beside our Fort Temple guy. How are you? Are you okay? You look all right. He's a pretty looking, good looking guy. Listen to our show.
Howard, something to keep in mind. I know Jamie's driving that as of today, speeding fines have more than doubled.
Yo.
Okay, so keep that in mind. Oh, we don't want anyone to get hurt through
believe
this.
Believe me, in rush hour in Toronto, there's no chance of speeding. we're just on Airport Road and, what did we just pass? Northwest Road. We're about 10 minutes away.
Give it 7.
7 minutes away. And a plane just landed. It could be my plane. I don't know.
Yeah, but that's 7 minutes if the traffic's okay.
Yeah, we got now we got some other person here. Hi. How are you, ma'am? She's very good looking. You know something, Fred?
Yeah?
I didn't know this. We have some of the best looking listeners.
Mm-hmm.
You really do. Oh, and while we're just passing the runway part, there's stacks of planes lined up. Boy, you hardly ever hear, you ever see that here at Pearson.
Oh, no. They
don't
wait to take off.
It looks like an airplane parking lot.
Okay, well, we'll get another update after the news, Howard.
In the meantime, here's Concan from CFNY FM 102. I'm Fred, and this is Humble in the cruiser, and we're right in front of a lady in a Toyota who's smiling at us.
Mm-hmm.
Hi. She's waving at you now, Fred.
She must be listening to another station if she's smiling at you.
Yeah, she's not listening to us. She's just smiling at us. We are actually now approaching the airport. Just past this Terminal 3. You seen this?
Uh-huh.
Looks like it'll be ready sometime in the year 2000.
Yeah, I know. It's something else, isn't it? What a project.
Oh, it's a beauty. Mm-hmm. But Freddie's got sports on the way. Kim will have traffic. But first, at 8:31 with the news, here's Barb.
Thanks, Howard.
Traffic and transit update.
The 401 in pretty good shape both ways across Metro. A little bit lighter than usual. You will find a few of the normal delays, though. It's also slow going southbound on the Parkway, Sheppard to York Mills, eastbound on the QE through Cawthron, and again, eastbound on the QE from Royal York to the Bay, and also southbound on the 427 exiting to the QE. Downtown, Queen Street closed between Sherbourne and Ontario Streets. We've got a fire in a laundromat and a broken water main southbound on Bathurst, south of College. And that's the CFNY traffic for McDonald's. I'm Kim Carruthers. Fred has sports next.
This track, Leprechauns.
Sports! A presentation of Labatt's. Immediately after the hockey game of the Gardens last night, Coach Doug Carpenter, he didn't look too pleased. In fact, he looked disgusted with the Leafs' shoddy 5-4 victory over the Quebec Nordiques. But later on, when he thought about the 2 points, he felt much better. The Leafs built up a 4-1 lead in the first period. Then, really, they had to hold on. In the third, they were lucky the Nordiques didn't tie it up. And please, don't forget, the Nordiques are the worst team in the NHL. We got trapped a little bit, said the coach. They knocked us off our game, but we won. It was a chippy game with some highlights, like the performance of Vincent Damfus. He had a goal and 3 assists. Gary Lehmann scored his 43rd goal of the season, then had to leave in the third period with a shoulder spasm. Oh, and they can be awful. But he'll be okay. With the victory, the Leafs extend their home unbeaten streak to 6 games, and they pull back within 3 points of second place St. Louis in the Norris Division. Leafs are in Detroit tomorrow night. On Saturday night, they host the Wings. Detroit beat the Islanders 4-3 last night. Wings have pulled within 1 point of Minnesota for that final playoff spot in the Norris. Rangers got by Washington 3-2. Rangers now have a 4-point lead atop the Patrick. Hartford dumped Montreal 3-1. How about that? L.A. beat Edmonton 4-2. This was a nutso game in L.A. 7 players thrown out for fighting. 85 penalties were called in the game, which sets an NHL record. This totaled 354 minutes. Vancouver and Philadelphia tied 7-7. Pittsburgh beat Jersey 2-1. Scary news about Mario Lemieux. Apparently his career could be in jeopardy. He was told about his back problems years ago, but never took advice on how to avoid chronic problems. So now he's in a real pickle. The baseball lockout continues. There were no new talks yesterday, but the possible start date gets bumped to March 10th. George Bell is in Dunedin. Every year he refuses to report until March 1st. This year, despite the lockout, no different. George arrived in Dunedin yesterday. Well, the Argonauts' best player is free to cut a deal with anyone. Running back Gil Fenerty became a free agent at midnight last night, and he's waiting for NFL offers. Argos say, within reason, they'll do all they can to keep this guy the thrill, and so they should. And there's a chance Calgary could end up hosting the 1992 Winter Olympics. The games have been awarded to Albertville, France, but that city is small. They're having problems getting the facilities. Rumor has it, if things continue to falter, the IOC will ask Calgary to take over. Now, those involved in acquiring the 1996 Summer Games for Toronto are concerned. They think two Winter Games in Calgary in a row. This might hurt our chances for bringing the summer games to Canada. We'll see. That's your sports, a presentation of Labatt's. More information at 9 o'clock.
The airport now.
You are?
Oh, yeah.
You made it.
How are you?
Fine.
And where are you going today?
Washington.
Washington, D.C. or Washington State?
Washington, D.C.
Well, thank you very much. My name is Howard. We're doing a radio show right now. And what's your name?
Mavis.
Sorry to bother you, Mavis, okay? Mavis doesn't like me. Okay, we're in line here, and I'm starting to cry. People are looking at me like I was, you know, an idiot, which is not unusual. How are you guys? Are you okay? Yeah, we're good, Howard. Just shut up and leave us alone. We're at Pearson International, where lots of fine people are today. And how are you? Where are you going to? You going to Las Vegas? Can you spend $5 for me? I love saying that. People never do they? You know, they say, oh, yeah, I'll take your $5 and bet it. Oh, I will. Listen, Fred.
Yeah, you know, Howard, I have a lot more faith now in the city, though. That was a pretty good time you got to the airport, I'll tell you.
Very good time, mm-hmm. And we didn't speed, mm-hmm. And things were very nice. The roads are good, but right now at Pearson, it's jammed. We're just tons and tons of people, and we're going to go through customs in a minute, so I'm going to go from the cellular to a payphone, mm-hmm. in about 10 minutes' time.
Oh, it's so exciting.
Oh, it is exciting. And in the meantime, we'll play some Tom Petty. And it's called I Won't Back Down at FM 102 CFNY.
CFNY, FM 102, that's Tom Petty, I Won't Back Down, I'm Dan Duran. I guess I don't really have to do that, do I?
That's no good. Okay. I thought I was going to get to do the disc jockey stuff if Howard wasn't on the line.
Well, I'm the producer of the show, and I felt like taking that break.
Yeah. Sunny and nice today, a high near 4. We're going to have some wind. Right now it's -6, and here's Kimberly Ann in traffic.
Oh, thank you, Freddie. Police investigating accidents eastbound on the 401 and the collectors east of the 400. That one's a multi-westbound jam through the area as well. Also problems eastbound 401 in the core, east of the Allen, and two problems on the 404 southbound, one south of Finch, the other south of Steeles. Queen Street still closed from Sherbourne to Ontario Streets because of a fire. Patrick called to report an accident on Ellesmere through Brimley. Delays on the Spadina subway line southbound at George Street. Give yourself lots of extra time. And the CFMY Street of the Day, Knob Hill.
Knob Hill.
I think that's where you live, isn't it, Fred?
Yeah.
That's CFMY traffic. I'm Kim Carruthers, back at 9.
The plan, go to Wonderland, it's in demand.
Well, we'll check in with Howard in a few more minutes. He's at the airport, and let's see if he can make that plane. But right now, this is Endless Night with I.
CFNY, FM 102, that's I, and Endless Night at 8:51. And I'm Dan Duran, along with Fred Patterson, and we're waiting for Howard to call back from customs.
Well, this is the thing, you know, getting to the airport is one thing, but that doesn't necessarily mean he's going to make the plane, because you have to go through that whole customs thing, and I can
just
see
it. It's a routine, yeah.
Oh, he's a shady-looking character. I can just see him right now spread-eagled against some wall in his underwear and some guy going through his stuff. He's not on the phone right now?
No, he's not called in yet.
Uh-oh, cause for concern.
Yeah.
But anyway, he's got, another 35 minutes to catch his plane, but again, at customs at Toronto International Airport, that may be difficult.
We'll see. It's 8:52.
We're all in this together, all together now. We can make it much better. Make it work together, we can work it out. We can make it together.
Ontario is the wealthiest province in Canada. But if we're to maintain our economic strength...
Egg?
Yes?
It casts quite a shadow.
Yes?
You're not much of a conversationalist, are you, small farmer?
No.
Raising the boom for you, the CFNY Coca-Cola Classic Boombox.
This weekend, if you're heading to the Hobby Show or the Canadian International Bike Show at Exhibition Place, be looking for it.
We're still waiting to hear from Howard and Customs. But in the meantime, Kevin Page, anything I want from CFNY, FM 102.
Anything I want.
Canada now. They're calling my flight. I'm at gate 91. I heard you guys talking about me having some trouble with Customs. I'm not the kind of guy, Fred,
mm-hmm.
that has any trouble with customs. I'm a nice, polite young man.
Yeah, I know.
And the guy at customs said to me, what do you do for a living, sir? I said, well, I do a little morning show. Mm-hmm. Never heard of you.
I went, well, that's pretty typical. But he said, you seem to have a nice radio voice. And then he started doing his radio voice as if I would audition him and maybe, you know, put him on the air.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah.
He said, what do you do for a living? You say, I do a little morning show. And he said, so you don't work.
Yeah, so you don't work, he said. You have no job. Nicole was nice enough at Air Canada. Hi, Nicole.
Hi.
Want to say hi? Say hi to Nicole.
Hi, Nicole.
Hi.
How you doing?
It's Fred. It's Fred. She's talking to Fred. Listen, you know, you wouldn't believe how many people there are. It's a 767 to San Francisco. Are you guys our crew?
No.
Oh, cool. I'm Howard from CFNY, by the way.
Hi.
Nice to see you. And what's your name?
Tristan.
You guys are like flight people, aren't you? Do you work for Air Canada?
Air Toronto.
Air Toronto. Can we just maybe the three of us, you know, captains, guys, and just on our way without the rest of these people?
What?
Can we just take a plane and go ourselves?
Sure, yeah.
Okay, we're gone. We had a private Air Canada flight. Fred, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Private Air Canada flight, we're gone. We got like a captain, a first captain or something, uh-huh. And we're out of here.
Oh, spread the rumor, Howard and a couple of stewardesses.
So listen, I'm going to leave you guys now, but they're calling my flight.
Okay.
And actually, you know, it's so busy here, and the regular phones are all jammed, so thanks to Nicole.
Okay, Howard, have a good time and watch yourself in San Francisco, eh?
What do you mean?
Well, for various reasons, you know, they have earthquakes and
earthquakes,
other and other stuff down there, you know.
Sure. You guys have a great weekend.
You too.
It's 9 o'clock now, and Mary Ellen has the news.
Good morning.
You'll find the 401 heavy eastbound in the collectors east of the 400. We have a multi-vehicle accident. It's also heavy westbound as everyone slows to look. Also problems eastbound in the core east of the Allen. Thanks to Dan for calling in problems eastbound on the QE as you approach Walker's Line. There's glass in the left lane that's backed up to Guelph Line. Also problems reported westbound QE in the same area. Two accidents causing delays, southbound on the 404, one south of Finch, the other south of Steeles. And in town, Queen's still closed from Sherbourne to Ontario Streets, a laundromat on fire. And that's CFNY traffic. I'm Kim Carruthers, Sports with Fred, next.
Classy soon, because for most people, a wedding is a classy occasion. Wear, the only way to celebrate.
Visit one of Classy's 10 metro area stores soon, including 3663 Mavis Road in Mississauga.
It's a swinging place.
Sports, a presentation of Labatt's. The Maple Leafs, they won last night. Yeah, they beat the Quebec Nordiques 5-4, but this was nothing to write home about. Leafs built up a 4-1 lead in the first period, but then literally had to hang on to beat this club. The 2 points, they come in handy. Leafs pull back within 2 points of second place St. Louis in the Norris Division. Gary Lehman scored his 43rd goal of the season, but had to leave in the third period with a spasm in his shoulder. Detroit beat the Islanders 4-3. Wings have pulled to within 1 point of Minnesota for the final playoff spot in the Norris. Rangers got by Washington 3-2. Hartford upset Montreal 3-1. Pittsburgh beat Jersey 2-1. L.A. over Edmonton 4-2. A ton of fights in that game. Vancouver and Philadelphia tied 7-7. There was no baseball settlement yesterday, so another day has been chopped off the exhibition schedule. March 10th is the new possible start date. Several CFL players became free agents yesterday, among them the Argos' Gill, the Thrill Fennerty, and there's a chance Calgary could end up as host of the 1992 Winter Olympics. That's your sports, a presentation of Labatt's, coming up at 9:30, 102 Magazine.
CFNY FM 102, that's Sash Jordan, and So Hard. Before that, the Pet Shop Boys, and What Have I Done to Deserve This? It's now 9:15.
Yeah, Howard's on his way to San Francisco now. He got a couple of days off Friday and Monday, and because he got a couple of days off, I wanted a couple of days off, so I weaseled him out, too.
Wow. Don't I get any time?
No, absolutely not. Either do you,
oh,
do you,
fine.
Dan?
No, I don't. I'll be here with Hal Harbour. And,
yes.
And
well,
so, Kim,
we'll have a good time together.
We'll guide Hal through this whole thing.
Hal Harbour filling in both tomorrow and Monday. The weather, sunny and nice today, a high near 4. There's going to be some wind, though, so maybe it won't feel so warm. Right now, minus 6, that's the last we heard from the weather office. And right now, here's Kimberly in traffic.
Well, thank you, Fred. Very heavy on the 401 eastbound in the collectors east of the 400, an earlier multi-vehicle accident being investigated. Two problems, one eastbound, the other westbound on the QE through Walker's Line. Still slow southbound on the 404 south of Steeles because of earlier problems. And downtown Queen remains closed from Sherbourne to Ontario Streets because of a fire. And also because of this, Sherbourne is closed from Richmond to Queen. And that's CFNY traffic. I'm Kim Carruthers, and I'll be back with more traffic this afternoon with Jim Duff.
This traffic update.
Than a beer. And less.
9:18, and as Howard would say, it's called 102 Magazine, and it's a wonderful show. He usually says that, doesn't he?
Yes, he usually does, and he's always right. 102 Magazine coming up in 12 minutes' time. Oh, Fred, you were asking me when the Ballard story, the Yolanda Ballard story, was going to air on A Current Affair, because we did that interview with the producer. It airs tonight.
Beauty.
So anybody wants to get the latest gossip on the Ballers Watch a Current Affair tonight. Coming up on 102 Magazine this morning, we're going to give baseball fans a chance to fight back against this strike.
Great.
There's an organization in the States that's coming up with some ideas. Mm-hmm. As well, we've got a piece from Pat McDermott on the future of space travel. A lot of people are saying that Mars is the next goal. And are we going to make it or not? We'll find out this morning. As well, yesterday we talked about driving in and around Toronto. And one of the major hazards of driving nowadays seems to be car phones.
Mm-hmm.
People more excited about calling out, doing business on their phone than...
We revealed that this morning.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, Howard and Jamie are always a major hazard. Anyway, we're going to talk about that this morning as well.
Okay, all that coming up in 11 minutes on the way. Del Bello and The Clash.
This is Toronto 102 Magazine.
Good morning and welcome. I'm Mary Ellen Benninger.
That was March 1st, 1990 on CFNY 102.1. That was the Humble and Fred Show. They played Inside Out by Crash Vegas. I loved that song. Crash Vegas, of course, was founded by Blue Rodeo's Greg Keeler and his wife Michelle McAdory before Keeler was fired and Colin Cripps took over. Fun fact, Michelle McAdory is the niece of Bob McAdory, who many of you know from 1050 Chum, but I knew from Global. I loved Bob McAdory. Bonus fun fact, you'll see Michelle McAdory in the video for Try by Blue Rodeo. Try, by the way, is an FOTM jam. That means somebody in the band has been on Toronto Mic'd. I literally spent hours yesterday putting together a playlist of songs by artists who have appeared on Toronto Mic'd. And I'm going to play this playlist at TMLX 13 on Thursday, September 7th from 6 to 9 p.m. We're at Great Lakes Brewery. That's 30 Queen Elizabeth Boulevard. Be there. Palma Pasta will feed you. GLB will buy you your first drink. We're going to have a great time, rain or shine. Speaking of great times, I just want to shout out Pumpkins After Dark, because there's a promo code to save you 15%. It's TOMIKE15. Go to Pumpkins After Dark. Buy a whole bunch of tickets. You will not be disappointed. It's a fantastic event in Milton, Ontario. It's in other cities, I'm told. But hey, this is Toronto Mic'd. Go to PumpkinsAfterDark.com to find where else this event is taking place. I know it's taking place in Milton. 15% off. FOTM15. Just do it. And while you're doing things, subscribe to The Advantaged Investor. Whether you already work with a trusted financial advisor or currently manage your own investment plans, The Advantaged Investor provides the engaging wealth management information you value as you pursue your most important goals. It's available wherever you find podcasts. The Advantaged Investor podcast for Raymond James. And while you're subscribing, subscribe to Life's Undertaking with Brad Jones from Ridley Funeral Home. I get to co-host that one. You're going to love it. See you all at TMLX 13, September 7th, 6 to 9 p.m. And come hungry, darling.